Scott Klatzkin here for Hens All Access exclusive after Delaware falls to Notre Dame 80-75. A tough game for the Hens. They battled, but we're here with former Delaware head coach and now the head coach of the Notre Dame Fighting Irish, Mike Brey. And coach, your former employer, the Delaware Blue Hens, come to town. They battled, but your team gets the victory by 5. Your thoughts on the contest?
Well, we were very fortunate to beat my old Blue Hens, and they're really good. I'm so impressed. I told Coach Ross after the game, I love his team. I love the momentum of his basketball program right now. I know you get a pretty good player back for the next game. I mean this as a compliment, you're a cocky offensive team. And that's a compliment. You just really know who you are offensively, a lot of weapons. And we were very fortunate to win. And I told our team the whole week, I said, this will be a good win for us, and it's going to come down to game situations. I am proud of my team. We had to make some big-time shots, defensive stops, make some free throws to escape.
Now, I know you're a big fan of Delaware Blue Hens basketball, even though you're here at Notre Dame. After you left, there was a lull for a bit for the Delaware Blue Hens basketball program. You've got to, as a fan, as a coach, like the direction Coach Ross has this team going.
Love it. And Delaware fans are very lucky. You got momentum in your program. But here's the thing. You got such a class act coaching your program, working with those kids, representing the university. I'm really proud to watch my old employer under Monte's direction. He's really good. I put it this way. I think I mentioned it to you on the radio. It's the kind of guy you'd want your son to play for. I'd send my son to him in a heartbeat. But their momentum is good. They've got really good players. Physically, they look a little bit more like an ACC team than a Colonial team. And I told every one of the kids and Coach Ross, I said, win that Colonial. I'll be cheering for you.
We know you will, and you know, a lot of cheering went on when you were coaching back at the Bob Carpenter Center. Can you take some time to reflect on your time spent in Newark?
Well, you know, it was so neat. I'm watching tape of Delaware to prepare for the game, and I'm seeing tape of games at the Bob. And I'm looking in the seats, and I'm going, I wonder if the Smiths still sit behind there, and I didn't see the Smiths. But, it was just so many memories there. And, God, we had great momentum. That place was rocking and had a fun team. I stay in close touch with all my former guys. I still have my place in Rehoboth Beach. So when I get back, John Gordon, one of my former guards, is down in Lewis. He'll come down. Greg Miller, Custutis Marcellonis, Mike Pagese, I see a lot on the road. He's coaching at Xavier. I had great kids, great guys. I worked for really supportive administrators and Edgar Johnson and David Roselle, and the fans were great to me and my family. You know, my family has just unbelievable memories. And when I'm back in Rehoboth in the summer, I see Blue Hen fans all the time, and they were all over me all summer about this game. They were all over me. So I knew it was going to be a tough one. We're fortunate to win. We beat a good team today.
Do you have a favorite memory that you can maybe look back out that it stands out for your time at Delaware?
Yeah, you know, when we beat Drexel in I think it was 99 in the championship game, we were rolling we were in such a gear offensively. We were offensively like this team. We could just really score it. We were beating people the last half of the America East season by 20. I mean, we were playing zone the last 7 minutes of the game, could be up 25. And we thumped Drexel, and the place was rocking. And it was just, you know, you're just able, you were, there was no, it was over with about 10 minutes left in the game, and the fans were celebrating, our team was celebrating, and we almost got an NCAA tournament win in Charlotte. I can still picture John Gordon had a three-point shot across from the bench to tie it with about 3 minutes to go. The darn thing rimmed in and out. They won by about 6, and that was our chance to maybe shock the world a little bit. But, that game is a key. You know, we had a great home court atmosphere. You know, people up across from me on that top row, because we made so many threes, used to put the threes up, you know, like they put the K up, and I remember looking up there, and just great memories, you know. Now, the locker room that I would go wait in, I always tell people, this is how you stay loose. Jay Billis was back doing the America East Championships then. I'd sit in the coach's locker room. That's the locker room UD changed in. So while I'm in there getting ready for a big game, here's a student putting on their darn costume. And I said to Jay Billis, I think they do that to keep me loose. The dang bird is putting his head on, and we're going out to play for the marbles. So those are some of the great memories, many of them. I haven't been through Newark in a while. I do want to see that practice facility because we want to build one. I heard it's beautiful. But looking, anytime I see the Bob on TV, I flash back. I'll tell you, I flash back to Tyrone Perry sitting on the rim. That's probably a picture that's in the hallways there after we won the America East Championship. So, great, great memories, a lot of fun. And I'm still connected to that state with people back there. And there is such a Delaware connection to Notre Dame. Football weekends here, I have more Delaware people come out. They'll bring me a Grotto pizza. They'll bring me some hoagies. Bring me crab cakes. You know, they drop it off with my secretary. So strong connection there. And I'll be back this summer.
Well, certainly some great memories. There's a picture behind us of fans storming the court. I was one of those kids when you guys won the American East, storming the court back at the Bob Carpenter Center. So many great memories. You're a legend back in Newark. And now that this game is over, we'll be rooting for you the rest of the way all season long, and we'll see you at Madison Square Garden. Thank you so much for your time.
Yeah, no, that's exciting. I told Coach and I told players, I'll see you in New York. Let's get two in New York. Let's us get one and you get one, and then we can go out and have some eggnog or something in the city, all right?
I appreciate it. Head coach of Notre Dame, former head coach of the Blue Hens, Mike Brey.